Honor is really embracing this whole dual lens camera malarkey with the new Lite version of its Honor 9 flagship phone. Not only do you get a double shoot around back, you also get one up front for all of your selfies. But are four camera lenses really better than two? Here's our full review. The original Honor 9 handset sported a 12-megapixel RGB lens backed up by a 20-megapixel monochrome lens, but the Lite version offers some very different specs. Here you get a 13-meg primary snapper alongside a more basic 2-meg lens. Now this means your photos won't be quite as crisp or packed with as much detail, but at least that dual lens setup means that you do get Huawei's wide aperture and portrait modes on board. These allow you to capture a subject with some nice blurry bokeh style effects to really help them stand out. You do lose some of that finer profile detailing, such as stray hair strands and so on, but the result is still effective. And the portrait mode throws in some beautification effects if your model had a few too many jars the night before. The Honor 9 Lite also offers up Huawei's Move and Pictures mode. This shoots a tiny slip of video with every photo that you take in order to animate your photo gallery as you flip through. It's not quite as seamless as some other attempts that we've seen, but it's good fun for parents and pet owners all the same. And as you'd expect from Honor, you get an absolute donkey load of special camera features packed inside that app. Not as many as on more premium monophones, however. For instance, there's no slow motion video mode, just a spot of time lapse. All the same, it's great to see manual controls for both photo and video shooting, which is definitely good news for any keen photographers out there. And if you're a bit of an amateur snapper, no worries. The Honor 9 Lite's auto mode is, for the most part, quite dependable. For instance, scenery shots taken in decent light tend to come out really well, with accurate colour capture to boot. Of course, as this is a budget snapper, the usual limitations soon poke their nasty little heads up. Contrast can certainly be an issue, so try not to shoot against any seriously bright skies or lights. You'll end up with a mixture of oversaturated bright spots and murky dim bits. There's a separate HDR mode which is supposed to help out in these situations, but it doesn't seem to have much effect. Likewise, the subjects in motion will often come out a bit blurry, especially if the lighting isn't quite perfect. Those parents and pet owners will certainly be struggling. And when you hit those low light environments, such as pubs or restaurants, you'll need to switch on that flash or else endure all manner of grain. Switch on over to the video mode and the Honor 9 Lite can capture up to full HD footage at 30 frames per second. There's sadly no option for 60 frames per second or 4K Ultra HD shooting, although you do get that beauty mode in video shooting so you can glam up your mates in real time. Video quality is perfectly fine for a budget blower, although as with the original Honor 9, there is a bit of an issue with image stabilization, in that there isn't any. Walk and shoot at the same time and you'll basically end up with shaky cam footage to rival the Blair Witch Project. But as long as you aren't moving all about the place, the results are often fine for capturing some treasured memories. That front-facing dual-lens camera boasts the same setup as the back effort, although the portrait mode doesn't seem to produce any extra bokeh. It just adds a bit of beautification when needed, which in our case is pretty often. However, the addition of hand gesture support means that you can set off the camera with just a flash of your palm, which is definitely a lot easier than fumbling for that shutter button. And the screen flash mode helps to illuminate your visage when lights are low. Two good effects. Check out our Honor 9 Lite unboxing and the full review is coming soon. Don't forget to give us a like and a subscribe and ding that notifications bell. Thanks for watching.